to assist.
Then the facilities there, we have radios, VHF radios. Then we have all our ILSs.
Your what?
ILS, instrument landing system. So these are the facilities of number within here, which is...
What's the new capacity you have here now before, compared to before?
Compared to before, recently they upgraded the communication facility. The ones they had before is at the old time. Now, what we have now is a modern text. Yeah, the at least the range, if we talk about range and stability.
What's the new range?
It's more than 200 nautical miles. VHF has a particular range it covers, so 200 nautical miles.
How many places can you cover from Enugu now? That's the only way we'll understand it.
Yes, Enugu has its own, what we call TMA. So we have a boundary we'll transmit up to you, then there are adjacent stations like Porakot, which is the mother station to Enugu, will take over. So Enugu has a limit. We pass the traffic, then Enugu, Portugal takes over.
And if we convert that one to the static mile we have, we'll have almost maybe about 300 kilometers from here. That means an aircraft in the air at the range of 300 kilometers will be able to pick our transmission from here. Having said that, we have a range we have to operate from, and that range, our radio can get to that range for any aircraft operating into Enugu to be able to communicate effectively with Enugu.
So here now it is. It's more than as anything you have to use
like. As far as Africa is concerned, we can beat our chest that we have modern equipment as far as communication is concerned in Enugu. Well, we might not have been able to have access to what is obtainable over there. But
why? Are you sure, or you are just guessing?
I have not been to most of. I have not been to most some airports outside Africa.
The instrument that Minister of Population has explained to us, as good as any other airport.
It's as good as any other airport in the world.
The statement that anybody is anywhere.
It's set to act equipment. That's what we have. Yes.
Yes, any questions on this? I think we just continue the tour, then we'll ask questions. So let's go to the terminal.
We have capacity here for 150 passengers, and with this construction going on, we'll be able to seat about 1,500 people comfortably. So we can see the additional capacity that has been added. So they, we along the road to generate revenue too, because we are not running a charity here. There are numerous shops that have been incorporated in this arrival of the international passengers. There are going to be a modern conveyor system being installed after the completion.
The glasses will immediately be installed.
Yes, that will take us to the runway. You know, before the building, the runway was the first place that the Honorable Minister had to do enormous work. The flying capacity of the new runway is for 747 Boeing. Yes, 3 kilometers by 60 width. So it's able to take such big aircraft that take a long haul journey. So. It is that should be installed. It's supposed to be the site is the other way, but the present administration too had a new apron here. You can see a new apron. This is small for the kind of aircraft I'm talking about that the runway was designed for, because too close to the building, the blast of these aircrafts are equally powerful. So we have a big place there, a new apron. Recently constructed, and a taxiway that can take aircraft there. And actually, it's that side that you are supposed to have the new building coming up with aerial bridges and all the modern facilitation equipment. They can land here. It's the same runway.
The terminal building is for processing all the passengers. The facilities actually enhances processing time, which is operation index for measurement performance. Yes.
Questions, please.
When is this project supposed to be handed over to you so that activities will pick up in full force?
You know, this project was started in December 2011, barely a year, and even before the contractor will get on site, it's an existing building. A lot of integrity tests have to be performed to be sure that this building will take the new load is being imposed on. So that caused some little delays before they fully came on site, but we are hopeful that on or before March will fully take over. As you can see, yeah, this year, we can't be last year, it's this year. So that's the target they are really working on, and it's achievable. Yeah, on or before February, March. Yeah, you still have about two months. You can see the way they are going, it's achievable. Most things are in place.
All right, my name is Jude from News Agency of Nigeria. I'd like to know the cost on which you're doing this job.
Well, the project is going for about 640 million. 640 million, about that.
Any question or additional information?
You know, the airlines are looking for market, and you can see this Southeast market is a spot one. It's actually going to be a regional hub, so they are eager to land here as soon as the facilities are ready. They're already making inquiries, and I can assure you that in the shortest possible time, it will come to pass. Thank you.
Well, first of all, let me appreciate the very aggressive airport program that has been started by my sister, the Minister of Aviation, Princess Stella Odua. She has brought a new revolution to the aviation industry, as we can see as we move from one part of the country to another. And I must commend her because all the projects which she presented to us at the Federal Executive Council are going on as planned. The Akanu Ibiam International Stadium, International Airport, was made international by President Goodluck Jonathan. Before the president, there was no international airport in the whole of the southeast of Nigeria. If you wanted to travel out of this country, you are an Igbo man or woman, you have to go to Port Harcourt or Calabar or Lagos or Abuja. There was no international airport in the southeast of Nigeria before President Goodluck Jonathan considered and established this international, promoted this Enugu Airport to international airport status. We know that the Southeast is made up of high-profile businessmen. This is the zone of private investment, private investors. You move to all parts of the world. There is nowhere you go in the world that you don't have Igbo businessmen and women striving to contribute their quota to the development of this country. And the president felt it highly unfair that the whole southeast of Nigeria, which is really a commercial zone in this country, will have no international airport. So the president decided to transform the Akanu Ibiam Airport into an international airport. And immediately, the promotion to international status, he accepted the program for, he directed that this airport be made truly international with additional facilities to expand its operations. And you can see here that the Enugu Airport that we're looking forward to see before the end of the first quarter of this year is entirely different from the old airport that used to be here. This airport will meet the highest international standards in terms of aviation equipment and handling of passengers. And we were with you at the Owerri local airport, and you saw the kind of transformation that has taken place in Owerri. And what is happening here is even far bigger than what you saw at Owerri. This will be at par with what we have done at Aminu Kano International Airport, what we are doing in Lagos, what we are doing in Abuja. And by the time this airport is finally, this new terminal building is finally completed before the end of the first quarter of this year, the Igbo nation can now say that justice has been done, that this president has done justice to you. I can't see why an Igbo trader from Onitsha or from Aba or Newi or Enugu will have to go far to other zones to be able to travel out of this country. So the president has decided to restore this facility here, not just for the purpose of politics, but that the Igbo nation comprising these five states deserve an international airport because of their contribution to the national economy and because of the fact that the Igbos generally are known to be one of the high profile people involved in business, building factories like we saw at Newi. And if people deserve to travel and do business, we believe this country is big enough for people to take off in different directions. Most countries that are big like Nigeria have international airports strategically located to reduce the suffering and pressure of those who want to go into business. So the president has translated his promises into action, and this is exactly what we are seeing here. In a couple of months, if you want to travel to America, if you want to travel to Australia, if you want to travel to any part of the world, the Igbos will no longer need to go to Lagos or Port Harcourt unless they are living there. If they want to stay here in the Southeast and travel to any part of the world, the president has given them that facility to do so in the interest of the development of the economy of Nigeria. Let me call on the contractors to work faster. We want to come and see by the end of March that this airport is delivered. We will not want to come here and hear of promises that are broken. We want to get this airport going as quickly as possible because passengers in the Southeast have been suffering a lot because of the renovation going on here. People can't land here at night, so which has made it very difficult for travelers. Please let us expedite action on this airport, and I know that the Minister of Aviation is very, very serious about all the airport programs that are going on in the country. So on behalf of the National Good Governance Tour Team, we appreciate the progress that has been made, and we urge for faster pace to deliver this airport. Thank you very much indeed.